in your face, all over the place.
We're online 24/7. 24/7.
You're listening to the hottest internet station.
Boomish Radio. We is radio.
It's your girl Coco. This is Sister Girl Show, and we back at it. We in the building. Woo! I got science on the ones and twos.
What's
this
up,
morning.
Everybody? Wake y'all asses up.
Hey.
Man, y'all check that. Illumination Radio, man. Straight out of Galveston County, man. They ain't playing no games. They got the industry media. Y'all want y'all music play, man. Hit up New Nation, man.
Yeah,
man. Man, they hear so, man, y'all can take the music.
You are listening to New Nation Radio, WNOD.
New Nation Radio, we is radio.
Yo, 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 what's up, everybody? Welcome to the show. This is Black Empowerment Movement, and I'm your host, Science. And if you are listening to this, man, you are listening to the revolution. Welcome to the revolution, all right? And it's good having y'all tonight. We started off a little late, but it's cool because we have the Red Light Special Show. Hope y'all had a chance to check that out. If you don't, go to the app right now and check that out. You can come back and listen to this later. It don't matter. Psych, you better stay here. This is a revolution. We are talking about the Million Man March tonight. We are adding up how many black women have been killed this year alone by law enforcement, all right? So y'all stay tuned. Don't go nowhere. You know how I do. I get straight to the music. And, yeah, this is Bim, New Nation Radio.
Like,
yeah.
Yo,
check out
yo. My men and my women, don't forget about the dean. This is not the most the king. Yo, it's about a thing. Yeah,
feel
yo.
Real good. Wave your hands in the air and lick two shots in the atmosphere.
Since you were looking for your friend, the one you let hit it and never called you again. Remember when he told you he was about to Benjamins? Yeah. You act like you ain't him, they give him a little trim to begin. Now you think you really gonna pretend like you wasn't down and you called him again. Plus when you give it up so easy, you ain't even fooling him. If you did it then, and you probably can. Talking out your neck saying you're a Christian, a Muslim, sleeping with the gin. Now that was the sin that did Jezebel in. Who you gonna tell when the repercussions spin? Showing off your ass cause you thinking it's a trend, girlfriend. Let me break it down for you again. You know I only say it cause I'm truly genuine. Don't be a hard rock when you really are a gin, baby girl. Respect is just the minimum. Think, but you still defending them now. Lauren is only human. Don't think I haven't been through the same predicament. Let it sit inside your head. A million women in Philly pen. It's silly when girls sell their souls because it's sin. Look at where you be in. Hair weaves like Europeans. Fake nails done by Koreans. Come again. Yeah. A win win. Come again. But it's rims and it's Timbs and it's women. Him and his men come in the club like hooligans. Don't care who they offend, Papa Yang.
Like you got yang.
Let's not pretend. The one to pack pissed out by the waist, man. Crissed out by the casement. Still the name of this basement. The pretty face man claiming that they did a bid, man. Need to take care of their three and four kids. Been the face in court case when the child support's late. Money taking heartbreaking. Now you wonder why women hate men. The sneaky silent man. The punk domestic violence man. The quick to shoot the semen. Stop acting like boys and be men. How you gonna win when you ain't right within? How you gonna win when you ain't right within? How you gonna win when you ain't right within? Come again.
Yo, come again. The red drink, come again. And sister, come again. Yeah, yeah.
Don't even say I love you no more. Saying how we feel is no longer allowed. Some people work things out and some just don't know how to change.
Let's go wait till the water is dry. We might watch our whole lives pass us by. Let's go wait till the water. Everybody knows that we're both torn apart.
Why do we hurt each other? Why do we push love away?
Let's go wait till the water.
No, no, we may.
We might watch our whole lives pass us by.
We might wait a whole
life. Let's go wait till the
awakened. Every rule I had you breaking. The risk that I'm taking.
your face all over the place.
We're online 24/7, 24/7.
You're listening to the hottest internet station.
WNOD, New Nation Radio.
Man, y'all check that New Nation Radio, man. Straight out of Galveston County, man. They ain't playing no games. They buzzing in the street. Then y'all want y'all music play, man. Hit up New Nation, man.
Yeah, send me
that music. 9 a.m. So, man, y'all get that good music to them, man.
Yo, what's up, everybody? It's your boy Science, and you are listening to New Nation Radio, WNOD. Yeah.
New Nation Radio. What is radio?
Welcome back to the revolution. Welcome back to BIM, New Nation Radio. It's your boy Science, man. So, like I said, man, first of all, if everybody don't know, this year is the Million Man March. It is actually October the 15th, right? October the 15th. Now, if y'all pay attention to what's going on with the media, there is no coverage. There is no, like, the first, like, what it was 20 years ago, right? It's the 20th year since the last Million Man March. The first Million Man March was televised. I was like 14 years old and I knew about it. We got a Million Man March that's happening in October, the 15th. I just found out about it. So why is the media hiding this event? All right? Now y'all think about that as we keep on going through the show and the program, all right? All right. So next, we get to these black women that the police, the law enforcement that we have to protect and serve us, they killing our black women. They killing them just like they killing us. And we just found out that they actually strangled Miss Sandra Bland. Rest in paradise. But they murdered that woman, man, and they killed her just because she was outspoken. She was an activist. She was, you know what I'm saying, against police brutality. So I see it as a strategic assassination of a black figure in American society. You know what I'm saying? In our culture, they are taking us down and they are assassinating us. You understand? And that's what they're doing to us. So I want to let y'all know a few names of the black women that have been assassinated by these officers. These officers, man, check this out. So we got Tanisha Anderson. She was 37 years old. She was struggling with mental illness, and she died after Cleveland police slammed her head into the pavement outside her family home, man. That was 2014. All right, check that out. And she was 37 years old. We got Miss Carrie. She was 34 years old. She was a dental hygienist. She made the wrong turn near the White House, and guess what? They fatally shot her. That was 2013, man. We got Yvette Smith. She was 47 years old, who was shot and killed by Texas police officers as soon as she opened her door. You know what I'm saying? They kill you. They killing our women when they open their door, man. It's pissing me off and it's making me mad. That's why we having this revolution. We have Natasha McKenna. She was 37 years old. She was restrained by Virginia police, shackled at the legs, and shot with a stun gun 4 times earlier this year. She stopped breathing and died at the hospital several days later. We got Rakia Boyd. She was 22 years old, living in Chicago, when she was shot and killed by off-duty officers. Man, what's up with that? We got Maya Hall. This lady was 27 years old. It was a transgender who was shot and killed by a national security agent after crashing a car into the government facility. So I don't know, you gotta be careful. You can't really just crash a car into the government facility. You know, they see it as an act of war. We got Shelly Fry. She was 27 years old, a mother of two who was shot by a Walmart security who accused her of shoplifting. Excuse me. They killed this lady for shoplifting, okay? We got Miss Darnisha Harris, who was only a teenager when Louisiana law enforcement, they fired two shots into her car while she was driving. You feel that? We got Melissa Williams. She's 30 years old. She died after Cleveland police fired 137 times into the car that she was riding in with Timothy Russell. We got Miss Alicia Thomas. Excuse me. Man, she was 35 years old. She was kicked to death. Oh, my God, man. What is we gonna do? It's time to pick up our weapons, man. She was kicked to death by Los Angeles police officers. We got Chantel Davis. She was 23 years old, shot and killed by plainclothes New York police officers. All right? We gonna go back to the show, and I see y'all in a minute, all right? New Nation Radio. Y'all just let that marinate, all right?
Yeah. Hi, what's up? It's your girl Jada Stone. You already know to quit calling my phone, but you can check me out on NNOD, New Nation Radio, the hottest station in the country. And if that doesn't work for you, check me out on Instagram at officially_JadaStone or my website at www.jadastonemusic.com. Quit calling my phone.
Welcome back to the revolution. Welcome back to Black Empowerment, man. It's your host, Science. Before we left, man, I just named a number of young black women, of all ages, that have been assassinated. We got to understand that these are the same people that hung us from ropes. But the only difference is they're not using ropes anymore. They're using guns. They're using the law. I be trying to tell people that these slave owners and these masters and these descendants, they hide now behind law enforcement. They hide now in counsel positions, in judge positions. So no matter what you do as a black man, you really messed up because you got these same racist and prejudiced people in high positions. So when you come to a court of law, you automatically going down, you know. So it's a sad day, but at the same time, it's a happy day because we know what they think we don't know. We know that we are the first people on earth. We know that the white man descended from us. We know that we was around every country on this earth before the white man touched down. We know that we was kings and queens. We know that we was betrayed by the white man. And we know that the white man should have his day. But I'm going to read something real quick, y'all. It was posted on the Black Empowerment Movement page, the group. And that's on Facebook. If you don't have it, go to it. Tell a friend, man. Join the page. We all part of the movement, all right? So, first of all, it say, for my black people, others portray black men as subordinate, weak, lame, emotional, little boys in the hood, right? Black people today own half of 1% of America's wealth. As soon as black people were freed in 1860s, whites controlled all the wealth. 148 years later, it's still the same. What you need to do is have a personal check. Have a professional check your contacts. Create your own jobs and companies. A two-parent household is necessary to raise a child. Don't trust whites, even if it seems like they are helping you. Segregating from whites is the only path for true freedom. Let me know how y'all feel about that. Then it goes on to say, now you have to sacrifice. Blacks have to be willing to let go of the European luxuries and be willing to die for the true cultural, political, education, and economic freedom. Our past generation died for the wrong goal, which was civil rights and integration, right? We black people must stop funding their oppressors by sending all our funds with them. You feel me? Blacks must sacrifice their fashion sense and give up buying expensive, authentic brand names. You feel me? Just stop giving the white man money. It goes on to say, black people must stop feeding their oppressors billions of dollars by purchasing the latest gadgets and technologies. Instead, they must support black-owned and up-and-coming technology and their companies. There's no freedom without sacrifices. You understand me? The people who die for us right now, man, they'll be ashamed of us. They die and they sacrifice. Next, you must take back your community by boycotting all the non-blacks, which include all major fast food restaurants, like Italian fast food restaurants. We got Chinese restaurants, Korean nail shops, Korean beauty supply stores, Arab corner stores. We got to stop supporting that. Stop spending money with them people. This is how we build our economy. You understand me? This is how we build that up. black people could never go to any of these ethnic group communities and set up shop. Why? Because none of these ethnic groups would spend their money with blacks, much less allow us to rent a store from their neighborhood in the first place. You know, they're not even going to give us no property. We can't even set up a neighborhood, but they are in our neighborhood. You understand me? It's time to take full control of your community. If y'all listening, this is part of the revolution. And I'm going to read a little bit more, and I'm going to let y'all go back to some music, man. And say, okay, look at education. Would Jews allow their children to be taught by the descendants of Nazi Germans? No. No. Hell no. So, you should not be sending your children to be taught by the descendants of your slave masters. Black children are being psychologically destroyed and miseducated in the public schools. You feel me? Most black people romanticizing when living in a war zone and belong to a group of people who owns practically nothing, no wealth, no nation, no resources, no technology. Negro, check this out. This is not the time to be singing, debating, dancing the jig, romanticizing, glamorizing, ghetto news reporting, profiting off the current state of oppression. You feel me? This is not the time. We gotta reroute the way we've been thinking, y'all. And I'm going to let y'all marinate on that. And I'm going to come back with some news about the Million Man March. I got a surprise for all my listeners, man. We might be going there live. Man, I'm excited. So, New Nation Radio, I'll be right back. This is Bim.
Bam.
Your eyes.
quit playing these love games. Tell me what you're gonna do, yeah. Quit breaking my heart, yeah. I'm breaking my heart, yeah. Breaking my heart.
It's your boy Science, and you are listening to New Nation Radio, double N-O-D, yeah.
New Nation Radio, with Ian's Radio. Welcome back to the show. Welcome back to the revolution, man. And I just gave y'all a lot to think about, man. It gave me a lot to think about. And if you are just tuning in, this is Black Empowerment Movement Radio, all right? So now you know. So now I catch up. Let's go. Okay. So when I left off, we was talking about everything that blacks need to do as far as being a stronger race, you understand me? And that was posted on the Black Empowerment Movement page on Facebook. Go join if you ain't joined yet. Go join that. And it was posted by Mr. Don Petaway. So shout out to that boy. I got a clip real fast before I go on, let y'all know about the Million Man March. I got a clip I want y'all to play. I want y'all to hear that for the play. It was posted by King Lack Sellers. So y'all check this out. Let me know what y'all think. Let me know. Shout out to that boy, man.
Chicken wings for that money, even though they was no good. Chicken wings for that money, even though they was no good. Uh-huh. But you do get something for your money. But when you put your money in the church bucket, what do you get back? Hope and a future after you die. And my position on that, if I have to die to experience heaven, I don't need that religion. Anyone who tells me that I should be content with accepting hell on earth, when the white man has his heaven here, and the Chinese man has his heaven here, and the Arab and East Indian has his heaven here, and they're even building their heaven in my ghetto, and you're telling me I got to die in order to experience what they are getting right now, that's a religion I don't need, because that's a religion for servitude. And so we have to put the black church to task and ask them, what are you doing without Jesus money? Let me tell you what they're doing with your Jesus money. Every black church in America has their money in a white bank. It is the white banks that are funding the regentrification ethnic cleansing movement. So all of us go to church. We put $3 million in the church coffers every Sunday. $3 million goes to a white bank every Sunday. And guess what they do on Monday? They take $3 million of black people's white Jesus money, and they give loans to white land developers and businesses and entrepreneurs to come into the ghetto where the church is located, buy up all the property, and force grandma out on the street homeless. Now, grandma been going to that church for 30 years. Grandma been giving that church $50 every Sunday. And lo and behold, grandma had to finally face the reality that it was your Jesus money that put your ass on the street.
Whoa. I want to pump my fist. Three fists for that, man. Something deep for y'all to think about, man. Just, you know, where the money go, you know, when you go to church, man. You know, we need to keep the money in the community. But everybody needs to get ready for the Million Man March, all right? October the 15th. And New Nation Radio will be live on the in the nation capital, on the site, on the scene. I'm happy about it. I'm proud, man. I'm getting real excited, man. Let me calm down. But yeah, we will be there, exclusive. We will be live, you know, recording it. We doing a documentary, you know, the whole trip. We go drive there. So if y'all want to join the revolution and come to the Million Man March, I encourage all the black men, red man, even the red man need to be there, the brown man, you know, come to the Million Man March. It's the second one in 20 years, all right? And to me, in my opinion, the last Million Man March, what has been accomplished? Not enough, but it's been an awakening, you understand me? So I'm not going to take away from what the black spirit has been trying to do, you understand, as far as waking us up. So there is an awakening, and there's something that we all need to be more familiar with, and that's our history and our roots, you know. So we got to go to the Million Man March, October the 15th, New Nation Radio, broadcasting live, Washington, D.C., the nation's capital. We got Farrakhan going to be there. I heard maybe Obama was going to be there, but I heard Obama might not show up because he's scared what Farrakhan going to say. You know what I'm saying? Farrakhan really mad at him, man. And actually, Mr. Farrakhan, man, he been really on some, you know, it's time to pick up our arms and it's time to defend ourselves. It's time to die for our kids. If we keep letting them assassinate us and kill us, our women and our men, then our kids will be left with no history of themselves, and they will be left with a cruel oppressor that's been oppressing us for generations after generations. You understand me? So I'm tired of sitting by the sideline. And the next show that's coming up, I got Andre Whiten coming through. I got Mr. Foster, Ronald Foster from Galveston College, doing an exclusive interview. And we're going to be talking about ways that we can start meeting up and forming committees, or, you know, just everybody coming together first, because you can't just talk about it. You got to become a structure. You got to become a group and a team and a unit. And we all got to be leaders, because if you got more than one leader, they kill one, you know, we keep on going, okay? So that's what it is, and that's what it do, man. And this is pretty much the end of the show. I really appreciate y'all for listening and tuning in. I want everybody to be empowered every day. Go out there and find out something new about the black race. I want to say rest in paradise to all the women that I mentioned on the show tonight, man. And we got to do something as men to defend our women. And we can't just sit on our asses and expect the white people to just, you know, change their mind and be like, hey, we forgive y'all for being mad. No, they mad at us for being mad because they fucking with us. Excuse my language. It's demoralizing. You understand me? So let's stand up. Teach your children the true nature of the black race. Let them know what their skin color really means. Let them know that we are the children of the universe. We are the true children of God. You understand me? And that's what it is, man. New Nation Radio, this your boy Science. I'm signing out. This is Bim. And y'all be ready for next week's show. Alright? Same time, matter of fact, a little earlier. I'm coming on at 6 o'clock, y'all. So y'all make sure y'all tune in. It's going to be a big show. And yeah, I had a good time. And have a great night. New Nation Radio, this is Bim.
Leaving all the competition in the dust.